So hi guys, I'm Don. I'm basically based in Dubai. I have been working with CIOB for the last 3 years, and I have completed my bachelor's in civil engineering and my master's in construction project management. So today we'll have, I have an experience just of 3 years. So we have taken this topic of adjusting the first workplace. So
yeah, sorry, Don.
This is off me. Yeah, tell you.
Okay, now I can see the screen. You can continue. Apologies.
Yeah, okay, fine. So yeah, so I'm a planning engineer. Since I've completed my construction project management, I took planning as my expertise, and I worked for that. I have also completed 4D simulations and 4D planning. So this is how we have done our CIOB student membership. I was a little aware of CIOB back in India because we have not yet established our chapter over there. However, once I came back to Dubai, I had the visit, and while I was doing my construction project management, I did my student membership. Now I'm an applicant for MCIOB. Hopefully this year and or the next year starting, I'll be a chartered. So I would request you, everyone, to become the CIOB student membership, and I would explain you why it would be beneficial for you in your student, while you are studying. The basic, you can actually have the membership free of cost, so you're not paying anything, and you become a part of our community. So in that, what we do in UAE, we have toolbox talks, monthly one or two maximum. So we have toolbox talks where we take a topic and we start discussing on how we could improve and the current scenario, and the guys who have more experience from maybe like FCIOB guys, they would come and explain how they started that topic. Maybe it could be safety related or a BIM related, and they would explain us how they have seen the growth of that topic. So it's like a knowledge sharing platform at that time. Then we have the university talks. The university talks are my favorite one because I get to talk with my students, like who I am. I've been an alumni of Period One University. So I go back to my university and we have a chat over there and discuss what they can do for better, when they come out. I would always want my students to have something more than the others. So that's why basically this helps you where to get a job. That's how I landed a job. So I would explain all this stuff in next 40 minutes. So the next goes for site visits. Site visits are the best part, and we have started, and I think I discussed with Teddy, and he said that he'll be starting the same soon in South African region. So I'm excited to see the pictures as well, because I cannot come over there and experience. So we have been to many site visits, and UAE being, especially Dubai being a region where construction projects are in the peak, you get to see some amazing projects in while we go for site visit. I'm working now in facade company, so I would not be able to see much projects and concentrate only in one. While I go to site visit, I have a chat there, I have a talk there, and that's how it goes. And the next one is like-minded outing. It's really boring when you go just for, just site visits or you just attend some webinars. We also have like-minded outing, which means we have a toolbox talks first, then we go work, we play a golf, mini golf, or some, you can see in the picture, we have been to the sustainable city. It's a city in UAE where they have planned everything in a sustainable way. So we always have that chat. So we get to interact with everyone. It can be a guy from
NCIOB.
Yeah, and also student membership. So the next ones are webinar, and as this is a part of webinar, you'll be interested. So we do many topics. One of my favorite was the drone in construction, because I'm a planning engineer. So we actually worked close with the drones and all. So it was a great experience knowing more about drones and how we can use the data gear taken from the drone and use it for planning, quantity survey, everything. So if you're interested in the topic and you would like to know more about the topic, what we do in UAE is we get to our UAE hub committee and explain them, say, this is a topic that I would like to know. And can you find an expert guy over there? And they would surely find, because it's a huge network which we have here. So this is it. And this is my personal milestone. So the left one is the Royal Atlantis.
Sorry to disturb you. I don't know if it's only me, but I'm actually seeing your first slide.
Okay. Can you see now?
It's still the first slide. Can anyone else see anything besides a slide written today's presenter?
So that just changed for me now. It was on webinars and like-minded people before it switched.
Oh, so it changed.
Oh, so
yeah.
We're here.
Yes.
Teddy, the issue is only for you, I guess, then.
Okay, I guess the issue is with me. No, you can continue, Don. Thank you.
So the next one is my personal milestone. This project, the Royal Atlantis Resort and Residence, is the first project where I went with my CIOB team and had a site visit on this project. It was an extremely tough and, the project itself was very tedious and we had to go around, learn. It's just a one-day site visit, but it's actually great that you have to experience all this as a member, as a student member. You need not be an MCIB, FCIB, or an applicant. You can just be a student member, hop into some site visit and have a network over there. And one more thing is, when I went here, Royal Atlantis, I interacted with the project manager over there, and they offered me a job in Saudi Arabia. So this is how you start networking. Once you start networking, you get the doors, more doors starts opening up and you start discussing your opportunity. So this is my timeline. So I completed my undergraduate in 2018. And while I was doing undergraduate, I was interested in planning. So I have completed Primavera Basics, if you guys are aware of the planning sector. And I have completed Microsoft Project, all those softwares. The next one, in 2019, I completed my construction project management. I worked with Eversendai, a Malaysian company. So in there, for 6 months as a trainee, after which I came to Dubai and did my master's. And then I moved to Kier, K-I-E-R. Kier is a company in UK. And I was a junior planning engineer for them. So I worked with Expo, Dubai Harbor. These are some projects which are, Expo, I'm sure that you guys would be aware. So that's how it was. And recent achievement, I have won Young Civil Engineer Award in Middle East region. So
sorry, Don.
A project of 100. Yeah.
Again, I have to currently disturb you. Sorry. Can you please stop sharing and then reshare?
Yeah.
Because I'm seeing also in the chat box that the presentation has actually frozen.
Okay. I don't know what happens.
I think if you can just stop sharing and then reshare.
Now, what do you say? Teddy, is it fine now?
I'm not seeing anything as yet, but if anyone else is seeing you, they can just quickly write on the chat box. Nothing as yet.
It's weird because I think I've started sharing the screen. Okay, I'll do one thing.
I'm actually thinking, maybe if I could share.
You could share, no issues.
There's one comment from Petra saying it's coming across the sea. So it's coming all the way from Dubai to sub-Saharan Africa. That's why it's quite slow. Okay. Just quickly, there we go. I found your presentation. I'm not sure which slide you were on, but I'm just going to share now. Please confirm if everyone's able to see.
Perfect. I can see yours. I don't know. So can you go four slides ahead, like back? Four slides back.
Oh, four slides back.
Yeah.
Okay, just tell me when to stop.
Yeah, the timeline is fine.
Okay, perfect. Raj, you can go ahead, Don.
Yeah, so as I was saying, so this is my timeline and expert in planning and BIM. So we will discuss more about it in the coming slides. Then can you just change it to the next slide? Teddy, the next slide, please.
Now my laptop is slow. Just a second, apologies everyone. So you were on choosing your future goals.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can go ahead, Don.
So these is a small, a future goals for myself. So since I have done my certification has completed for Revit, Architect Revit, and 4D simulation, Syngro and Navisworks. These are the software which helps you to do planning in 4D simulation. And membership in CIOB is still happening. I think maybe early next year I will be completing. So as I say, everyone should have a goal, and these are my short-term professional goals, not the personal one. Professional goals. So when you set a professional goal, you get motivated to start working for it. I have been waiting for MCIB because MCIB requires 3 years of experience, and one more month I think I'll be completed with my 3 years, after which I'll start with my MCIB. Can you go to the next slide, please? So how do I stand out? When we are in the university, and as our, the series of this employability goes ahead, we have completed resume, LinkedIn, and now I'm just checking how will I go and stand out. Because when you come out of a university, everyone would have the same resume and everything. You could actually stand out by choosing a path, as I have discussed with one of our student member in South Africa today. He said that we could actually choose from project management and QS, but I'm not sure how it works there. You could actually have more options. You could go for a QA/QC, you could go for as a site engineer, or you could actually go as a draftsman, you could be a BIM coordinator, a BIM professional, every stuff. So I will explain all this, especially BIM and planning. The other, I'm not sure how it can work out. So the first one is choosing the path. Once you have selected the path, you start setting the goals. Like if you want to become a planner, you start learning about the softwares regarding the planning and how it can work, reach out, and you just set the goal. And these small steps will help you to achieve your main goal of getting a good job and as soon as you complete your universities. So once you have done that, the third step, Teddy, can you just go to the next slide, please? Working on goals. It's always easy to select the goal, start working. Selection of goal is the most easiest one, but the working on goal is the toughest. It's really tough. Once you start working on maybe a software, you start working on a software like Revit, then you start learning the goal. The goal is the Revit, but when you start learning, you will understand it can be, it's not my cup of tea. I don't like structural engineering personally. I don't like structural engineers because they calculate more when you could actually do it in a software, which I don't find any sense. I'm sorry if you have any structural engineer in this meeting, but this is how it is. So you could actually, once you start working on goals, you will understand what is your expertise and what is your weakness. You could either concentrate on your expertise and become an expert on one single topic, or you could actually broaden your table and you could actually have more dishes. So the next thing is you have worked on goal and now is the revision. Maybe you just come ahead and say, no, I don't want to become a draftsman or site engineer. I would like to go into QAQC. You could actually do courses which will be related. Again, revise the goal. Once you revise the goal, again, you do the 2, 3, and 4, the same steps. Work on it, set the goal, work on it, and revise the goal. If you have done, okay, I have completed, this is the best thing I could do, then stop in the third one, and that's it. You have achieved your goal. So this is how it will be. Yeah, so the next one, next slide, please. I think I have a question from Masina, wanted to ask for the BIM certification. It's limited to have a degree in civil or cancel the degree in QA. So yeah, I will discuss regarding that. I was having a discussion early this week with Teddy that since you are in universities, I could actually help you guys. If you guys are interested, you can talk to Teddy and I could go through with you of some of the courses which I have completed and I could give you a glimpse. It's any Friday, since it's my weekend and Friday I will be available. You could just ping Teddy saying that, Teddy, I'm interested in Premiere or P6 or Revit or AutoCAD. And once he gives me the confirmation, I could actually help you with learning the courses. I cannot assure you I will teach you maximum, but I could give you a glimpse, the working on goal and setting a goal. It's just like, as she has asked, QSCM can also pursue. So the BIM, we have a 2D structure. When you start a project, you start as a rough sketch, then goes for a 2D, which you do it in AutoCAD. That becomes, software for 2D is AutoCAD. Once you have completed 2D, you have to present it to your client with 3D. That will help you with Revit. So this is not a complete BIM. A BIM is like you have to have a whole concept of Revit architectural, structural, MEP, all those stuff. So BIM is not like once I complete 4D or 5D, it is done. A BIM model should help the client to understand every single concept of his project. Maybe he has a air conditioner, and when he clicks in the future, what is the QAQC, what is the connection, where has it been there, who is the manufacturer, everything you can have if it has a BIM model. So I can help you till 40, because after which I have zero interest. Since I said 3D is like you have a three-dimensional structure and you showed your client, see, this is how your home will look in maybe in 1 or 2 months. But the 4D is what I'm interested in, and that's the planning. Planning, 4D becomes the 3D structure becomes into time. So you add time and you say that, see, the slab can be casted in 21 days. The columns can be erected in 31 days. So all these will be reflected into your, you know, into the 3D structure, and it will be as the timeline. BIM and planning, these are my expertise. So I have said to you, if you want to know something else, maybe like QAQC or safety, I could help you more, but I'm not an expert in that. So any courses, if you are interested out of Revit, AutoCAD, Primera Basics, and Microsoft Project, I could help you out. No issues for me. I could spend 1 hour, if for 2 or 3 Fridays, I could explain one course. So when, especially for the guys who have done construction project management, planning will be a best option for you. The next is the internship. Once you have done, you could go for internship or site works or construction organization like MCIOB. CIOB will help you out for selection department, because once you go to a site, you will understand how many departments are there. It is not only QS and CA. It is more like you have QAQC, safety, site manager, site team, then QC team, then site execution team, site logistics team, all these are there. And all they require is civil engineers. So it doesn't matter if you're from CPM, like construction project management, or you have completed QS. QS is just, you are getting specialized. And I'm really happy that you could do that in that part of country where you just do 1 year in QS and become expert in QS. It's a good option. We don't have that here. I had to complete 4 years of my civil engineer, learning everything and then just go ahead. So this is how it works. So this is my offer for you guys. So if you want, I could do that. No issues. Then it can be more higher. Targeting your first job. I don't know if you have started facing this. This is what I faced. Where we have a conversation. Everyone wants a job and everyone wants an employee, but no one is ready to give for a fresher. And this is the hard reality. It is not, you cannot see it as a meme and just leave it out. This is the hard reality, how it works out. No one gives you a job, so you have to stand out as much as possible. So resume is mandatory. You could have a single page resume. However, make sure your resume has this, you know, the software which recognizes all this letter one. I don't remember the exact software which they use. So there is a software which checks out their requirement matches with your resume. And if you have done some very fancy resume, it doesn't work most of the time. Maybe it works and we don't know what software they use. So that's make it simple. But your resume should be in numbers, speak with numbers and speak with your courses. That will be the most helpful one. Then networking. CIB, this is why I say CIB is the best platform where you could actually start network with people. Now, we are networking from one part of the world to the other part. So this all can be helpful for you at any point. So the next is the core organization, the MCIOB. So the next two, the next slide, please. Okay. What do employees, okay, now imagine you have completed your resume, your LinkedIn, you have got a job, and now what do they look for? A young graduate, a transferable skill. You should be able to do multiple work. They don't want to hire a guy who is saying that, okay, site engineering, this is my work, I won't do anything else. No, that doesn't happen in civil engineering. Now I'm doing QAQC, QS, then I have also been, especially when you do CPM, construction management, people think that when you do construction management and come out of the university, they expect you to manage a project. It won't happen. It will happen only when you have the experience, and people do understand that, trust me, people do understand. But once you start your first day, do not be like, I'll only do this team, or you know, I'm just a CPM student. No, involve as much as possible. The next one is the team approach is as much as important as any other, because you start discussing your issues inside or the design in the site with your seniors. do not be afraid. It's a team approach. You just start talking with them and they are sure they'll help it out. Have a strong foundation. This is what I'm trying to help you out with. Once you have a strong foundation, you can actually do the rest of all those stuff, like transferable skill, team approach, long and slow steps, digital skills, all those. Once you have a foundation, you can easily construct a building. That's the basic concept. So have a strong foundation, learn what you are doing right now in college, and it will be helpful for you. Then long but a slow step. Take a step by step, but it should be a calculated step. Do not take a wrong step. For example, you move from one team to the other team, maybe QAQC to QS. It's a total different concepts. But in your part of the world, if you feel QAQC has more of opportunity, it's not wrong to move at the very young stage, because now you have options to broaden your area of expertise. But once after you have completed 20 years of experience in QAQC and you're saying, I want to move as a QS, no one will accept you. So that's why I say take a long but a slow step. The next is digital skills. It's a mandatory to have a digital skill. Anything, basic concepts like Excel, PowerPoint, Word, Revit, 2D structures, 3D structures, 4D structures. So once you have all this, I think it will stand out, especially if you have a digital skill and a strong foundation. Tell you the next one, please. A positive attitude. I'll explain a positive what. Yeah. So this is what a positive attitude for a freshers look like. Your boss may ask you to do something on Friday at 5 p.m. and you have packed everything. This is a real life story of mine. You have completed your work, and this happened today. I have completed my work at 6 p.m. It was supposed to complete at 5, and I completed my 6. And he was like, Don, can you do that work? Of course I could do. So I was working till now, and I have to work again for another 2-3 hours. So it will be a slow and boring weekend. But you start learning. Whenever your boss gives a work, do not consider it as a burden. Consider it as a experience, so that you can, when you become a boss, you could actually give the work to someone else. If you don't know what you are doing, you cannot guide someone else to the same work, to do the same work. So this is how this is my concept. Now I have been expert in QC, QS, project management. I could manage a project all by myself. So that's because you start with low and get involved as much as possible. So the next one, please. What to expect on first job? On the first day, you are going there. This is how I look. Not so small, but this is how I look. Wandering around on my first day of work, I was like clueless, complete clueless. No one expects you to start working on the first day, but they'll start expect you to work on the second day. So first day, especially in our industry, there is nothing called as 3 month. In IT, my friends have 3 months of training, after which they have put into a project and then they start working. For us, it is not like that. First day will be the site induction, second day will be our work. So that's how interesting ours is. At least for me, it is interesting because I don't want to be trained. Already I've trained 4 years. So this is how it works. Never stick to a single department. We have already discussed this. Be an open book and learn as much as possible, because whatever you learned in your universities, not sure if you had the differential calculus or structural theories, this all will not help you once you have completed your 4 years and you are into a job. The only one thing which will help you is getting involved with others, asking questions of how the site works, how should I do this work, how can I reduce the time and cost. In our field, you are extraordinary if you could reduce the cost and time. So this is what you should have always in mind. So how do I reduce the cost, improve the quality, and also have a less duration for completion of work. Never stop learning. If you stop learning, then you become old. That's it. That's the whole concept. You could do a small course from a free online course or plan for your MCIOB. All this will help you to stay active and get to know what is happening in our industry all over the world. Mistakes happen, but that's okay. Every day you do something or the other which is wrong, according to the seniors, because you know they have done in a different way, and you come over there and start in a different way. They think it's wrong, but you could actually prove by in a soft way. Do not be rude. In a soft way, say that, see, this is how we could do, reduce the time, and this software will help that out. So this will help you a lot. Mistakes happen, but that's okay. But never ever do the same mistake second or third time. It's really annoying. It's really annoying. This was my first advice from my boss. So you can do mistakes, no issues, especially in this part, in this stage, since this is your first job. No one wants you to be a genius. Everyone wants to be like, okay, this guy's learning. Okay, so we could give him more work, so he'll start learning more. So that's how you should have an approach. The next last point will seem to be a small, you know, it's just like organize your desk. So once you start organizing your desk, I know it is a bit kiddish or ridiculous to have this as a big point, but organizing your desk helps to, you know, when your boss comes and sees your place. So this shows that, okay, this guy is an organized guy and has everything in place. Everything he has, you know, a copy, everything. And it just gives a pleasant look on you and others as well. The guys who sits next to you will not be happy if you are a clumsy guy. Organize your desk. That's my last one. What to expect on first job. Can you move to the next slide, please, Teddy? So I'll explain you with my first struggle. So my very first struggles were drawing skills. I'm not sure if you guys have this experience, but for me it is the same thing. Just a second. Yeah, sorry. So this is in our universities, they teach us many things, but not how to learn or how to look into a drawing. This meme which I have done is a staircase, and he has constructed in the same way how the drawing is. It is not to be blamed. Maybe it is his first day and he wanted to impress, and this is how he has impressed. It's just like how the drawing is. This issue can be sorted out once you have, you know, like if you have any mentor with you, you could just ask them, can you just share your drawings around, look around the drawings. It is very important that you know a drawing, how to learn. How to look into a drawing is very important. The next one is the technical instruments. The instruments, if you have you know, the practical classes, the instruments that you are using right now in your universities need not be the same as they do in the work site. In Dubai especially, they use more sophisticated and more hard to use technical instruments so that the result will be better. So when I came here, they gave me you know, a leveling stuff, a digital one with laser. I had no clue how to use it, so I had to learn that. Drawing skill, I had no clue, I had to learn that. The next is team meeting every for us every Sunday it happens, and we plan for what is happening for the next week or the coming week. So every time when I used to go as a beginner, I had no idea what they were discussing and how to talk to them. Or, you know, they all are experts and you have just started. So there is a huge gap between you and them. So you know, they'll start discussing many options and you'll be like, okay, you could do that. But no, there will be some issues, and that's why they have not discussed that topic. So that's how, these were my very first struggles. And I think, and I wish you guys don't follow the same, but it will happen, especially the drawing skills. Seriously, some MEP drawings are the toughest. if you have someone working, or if you know someone who is working in MEP, you could get their drawing, look at their drawing, and okay, so just have an idea how it is and how it happens. It doesn't cost you anything. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't take much time to learn or anything. It's just like experience, how you have to draw, learn the drawing. And the next slide, please. You guys may think this is the last struggle. No. Our struggle in civil engineering continues. Every single day, you'll have a different problems and a different solutions. You can never have a same day, like you can never have a, every day as a Good Friday or Monday. It is a roller coaster. But the best part is when you wake up, I usually think, okay, today what will be the problem? And by the end of the day, I'll be like, okay, I handled this problem very well. So, and I never have a free time. I usually take classes or have webinars, or I do some projects for CIOB. I'm in Vision 2030. I'm a team leader, you know, in Tomorrow's Leader. So it all happens like that. So you keep yourself busy, and the site work about. I have site work even now. I have to go to site at 11 o'clock in this time. So, and this is a weekend. Everyone else enjoys. We civil engineers always have some work to do. So this is it. So I think I have taken 40 minutes to wind it up. So yeah,